maturing, these separating walls will disintegrate, and finally two theca of one lobe will fuse to become one. So it appears to be dithecus at maturity, but tetrathecus in immaturity. In most of the flowers, it will be in this manner. There are exceptional plants like Wolffia where two lobes are there and each lobe will carry only one theca. And there are plants like Archaeotherium in which only one lobe is there and one lobe will carry just one theca. So tetrasporangiate, bisporangiate and unisporangiate condition. Now the next topic is microsporangium. These thecas inside which the microspores or pollen grains develop are called as microsporangia. So a typical anther will carry four microsporangium. Microsporangium in common language is called as the pollen sac. So if a section is made, a diagrammatic section of it will look like this. There are various walls, layers of the wall which surrounds the microsporangium. The outermost wall is called as epidermis. It's a normal layer of tightly packed cells, flat cells, which covers the whole structure as a one layer. It's a single layer generally. And then inner to it is endothecium. Endothecium is the layer which carries the fibrous thickening, and these thickenings are made up of cellulose and lignin. And they are important as they are hygroscopic in nature. So when the anther has to dehisce or it has to crack open to release the pollen grains, endothecium plays an important role. There is a particular place in the endothecium which is called as the stomium. Stomium is the place where thickenings are absent. So whenever the anther is going to crack open, it opens at the stomium point because it is the weakest portion. Endothecium is also a single layer. Inner to endothecium there is 1 to 3 or generally 4 layers of which are called as middle layers. All these three layers are protective according to NCRT of the biology, and they help in the process of dehiscence. The innermost layer, which is in contact with the sporogenous tissue or surrounds the sporogenous tissue immediately, is called as the tapetum. Tapetum is the main layer because it is nutritive in nature. It provides nutrition during the process of formation of pollen grains. It develops Jewish granules. These granules are important for the development of sporopollenin. Sporopollenin is an important portion of the wall component of pollen grain. It also prepares pollen kit. Pollen kit is a modified form of carotenoids and flavonoids, which are important for being sticky, and they stick to the beak and the legs and the wings of the insects. Tapetum also produces proteins, which are important in pollen crystal interaction. This interaction is important because if germination of pollen grain will take place, it is controlled by this interaction. And tapetum also releases enzymes and hormones. There are two types of tapetum, invasive and glandular. Invasive tapetum is the tapetum in which the cells will disintegrate soon enough, and as they disintegrate, they release the nutritive content which surrounds the sporogenous tissue. Glandular is a type in which there is no disintegration which takes place. So slowly these cells will release the nutrition out for sporogenous tissue. Please remember, all the cells of this structure are diploid in nature. Tapetum is the only layer in this whole structure which may carry two nuclei. The reason is it undergoes karyokinesis but not followed by the cytokinesis. They are big cells with nutritive cytoplasm. Microsporogenesis. It's the process of formation of microspores inside the microsporangium. It starts with the pollen mother cells, also sometimes referred to as microspore mother cells, which are diploid in nature. These cells undergo meiosis first and second to form a group of four cells. Each cell will be haploid, and the four cells together are called as microspore tetrad. Now, microsporogenesis involves karyokinesis followed by cytokinesis. The cytokinesis involved can be either successive or it can be simultaneous. If it is successive, every mitotic division or karyokinesis will be followed by cytokinesis. So it is most common among monocots. And simultaneous, when meiosis first is not followed by cytokinesis, but the cytokinesis of these two products are going to take place simultaneously. So it is called a simultaneous cytokinesis. It is most common in dicots. Dicots generally carry tetrahedral type of arrangement of the microspores in a tetrad. Monocots generally carry isobilateral. There are other various types also possible. These are the various diversity of the arrangement of the pollen grains or microspores in a tetrad. Now, there are some exceptional plants also. For example, in Typha, compound pollen grains are formed. Compound pollen grains are those pollen grains in which the resultant cell of the tetrad do not separate from each other and will remain together in the same condition. That means when they are carried in the form of tetrads, not as individual pollen grains. Now, pollinium. Pollinium is found in Calotropis, also found in the Orchidaceae family or orchids, in which the pollen grains of a sac stay together. So all the pollen grains of an anther sac